is carried out at Department of Microbiology, University of Dhaka. We all know about Staphylococcus aureus. It's a gram-positive opportunistic pathogen. Usually, it's a normal inhabitant of our skin and upper respiratory tract, and it will be found in the respiratory tract of about 30% of human population. So employing a wide range of virulence factors, it can produce a lot of disease which can be mild to life-threatening. And when Staphylococcus aureus enters the circulatory system of its host, it can produce a lot of toxins such as exotoxin, hemolysin, and other toxins that cause bacteremia, life-threatening infections like infective endocarditis, necrotizing pneumonia, etc. So obviously, definitely, doctors are prescribing antibiotics to treat staphylococcal infections. But we know indiscriminate use of antibiotics leads to the emergence and dissemination of drug resistance pathogens in the environment, which is a public health concern. And interestingly, Staphylococcus aureus was once treated with methicillin, but few days after its use, starting of its use, it was found to be Staphylococcus was found to be resistant toward methicillin, which it termed as methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus or MRSA. And the gene that is responsible for conferring resistance is MAIC-A, that allows bacterial cell synthesis even at high concentration of methicillin. So we've focused on honey as the natural product that have huge antimicrobial potential, which is evident in scientific literature. And a study reported that if the honey can inhibit around 60 species of different gram-positive and negative bacteria, such as Klebsiella pneumoniae, Listeria monocytogenes, Salmonella type Vibrio cholerae. And we all know that these are the common human pathogens and caused different diseases such as pneumonia, listeriosis, cholera, diphtheria, etc. in human. So how honey exerts its antimicrobial potential? Its honey contain high sugar content and low water activity, low pH, and reactive oxygen species such as hydrogen peroxide and methyl dioxide. So here are the objectives of our study. We will first isolate and characterize Staphylococcus aureus from clinical samples. Then a molecular identification was carried out to detect methicillin-resistant gene, and only MRSA that were detected by molecular identification was subjected to honey experiments to see whether honey can inhibit those MRSA in laboratory condition. So these are the set of experiments that were performed to evaluate the antimicrobial potential of honey. So let's see the results. Firstly, we collected the clinical samples such as pus, blood, and we cultured them on mannitol sorbigar. It's a highly selective media for Staphylococcus aureus because it contains 7.5% salt. So only halotolerant bacteria can grow on this media. And we also performed gram staining and other observed cultural characteristics to confirm its isolation. Then for biochemical characterization, we performed a set of biochemical tests, but we mainly focused on three tests: catalase coagulase and beta hemolysis test. And catalase test is an important distinguishing characteristics between Staphylococci and Streptococci. So when we found Staphylococcus, then we subjected to coagulase test. Coagulase test differentiates Staphylococcus from other coagulase negative Staphylococci. And we also cultured them on blood agar, which contains 5% sheep blood, to see whether they can hemolyze RBC. So we found all the Staphylococcus aureus showed beta hemolytic characteristics. That means they completely destroy RBC in blood agar. Then we saw, start in antibiotic sensitivity pattern by using a widely used method called Kirby-Bauer antibiotic disc diffusion method. So for phenotypic detection of MRSA, oxacillin disc is used. Nowadays, cefoxitin is also used. So we found that 88% isolates are resistant to oxacillin. So we can deduce that based on phenotypic observation, on the prevalence of MRSA in those samples are 88%, and interestingly, vancomycin is used to treat MRSA. Nowadays, And we found moderate sensitivity of isolates to vancomycin, the sensitivity to isolates like linezolid, tetracycline, and ciprofloxacin are mentioned here. And the most important thing is that we found all the isolates are sensitive to imipenem and zentamicin. And so it's still working to treat staphylococcal infections. And we also performed a biofilm formation assay using microtiter plate assay. We stained biofilm using crystal violet and take the absorbance at 492 nanometer. And we classified our isolates. Only 12 isolates are found to be biofilm producer and others are non-biofilm former. So we classified biofilm former as strong, moderate, weak, moderate, or strong on the basis of the criteria mentioned below. For molecular detection of mRSA, we carried out make specific PCR. So the amplicon size was 533 base pair, and for further confirmation, we sequenced the gene and compared with the reference database, which is the comprehensive antibiotic resistance database. We found that the amplified product